I'd like for you to meet someone who's going to be a new neighbor of ours here in Florida, Mr. Walt Disney. The name Walt Disney recalls a lot of happy memories and becomes even more exciting when we consider that Florida will soon be an important part of the fascinating Disney world of entertainment.
Walt Disney is a man who started in the business of entertainment over 40 years ago and today has produced 600 films and has won 700 awards and citations. He's been honored with 34 Academy Awards and built just one Disneyland. It all started with Mickey Mouse and continued with Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs.
Hi-ho, hi-ho, it's home to work we go. Hi-ho, 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 hi-ho.
Disney is the drama of nature's wonderland. A coonskin cap riding across the television screen. Disney is laughter. Remember the fun of his flying flipper? Shaggy dog? And darn cat? Disney is pure entertainment. Disney is the magic storyteller, linking his skills with those of teachers, scientists, and doctors. He is the pioneer, bringing color to television with the wonderful world of color. Walt Disney is a man who had a dream to take raw land and with courage and conviction, build a magic kingdom called Disneyland. More than 6 million people a year visit Disneyland, the happiest place on earth. At the New York World's Fair, more than 120,000 people a day enjoyed the four Disneyland shows. General Electric's Carousel of Progress. Ford Motor Company's Magic Skyway. Illinois' Great Moments with Lincoln. And Pepsi-Cola's It's a Small World.
Disney organization carried out a tremendous amount of research before selecting Florida as the location for their new project. Here at this press conference held in Orlando, everyone anxiously anticipated the announcement of plans for the new Disney complex in Florida.
Well, Mr. Governor, This has been a wonderful reception that you've given us here. All the faces seem friendly, and we feel very much at home. And, of course, this is a big, exciting project for us, too, you know. I mean, in fact, it's the biggest thing we've ever tackled. This enthusiasm on the part of our whole organization and on the part of the people of the state of Florida really is a good start. And we hope that what we develop here will be a real credit to the state, a credit to the Disney organization. And I might say that when we were planning Disneyland, and we hoped that we could build something that would command the respect of the community. And after 10 years, I feel that we've accomplished that.
I don't think you've mentioned the amount of money, the initial investment.
That's a heck of a lot.
That would indicate the size of this project.
Well, there was a time in my life I didn't think there was that much money. You know? But, well, you see, the initial stage here has to top what we have, or at least be the equivalent of what we have now in California. And there's $54 million in Disneyland now, another $20 million this year. So we're going to have to start somewhere around there. Now, of course, that doesn't include the other facilities, the hotels and the things around it. Now, when you begin to put all those together, it's going to be well over $100 million plus, at least. But my big brother says we can do it. He's a money man.
It is a big job for Floridians as well as for Walt Disney. It's easy to foresee the untold potential of this project in all facets of economic growth. By way of an introduction, and using an old cliche, you can't argue with success. Look what happened in Anaheim, California.
This was Anaheim, California, 10 years ago. This is Anaheim today, 10 times larger and millions of dollars richer, all because of tourist money generated by a unique recreation industry called Disneyland. Since its opening, 50 million people, or over one-fourth of America's population, have come here. What has this meant to Anaheim? Independent research organizations have shown that in 10 years, almost $1 billion have been spent in Orange County, $273 million inside Disneyland, and more than $555 million outside for food, lodging, clothing, and a wide array of goods and services affecting every kind of business. This growth is reflected in receipts from other commercial, recreation, and tourist attractions in this vast Orange County area. Disneyland's impact on Orange County has attracted some of the major industries. Some 250 enterprises employing 33,000 people with a payroll of more than $109 million annually. The effect has spread to schools, libraries, and residential areas. Even to influencing the American League California Angels to come to their new 50,000-seat sports stadium. This, then, is the story of what has happened over the past decade to a city and a county. And as Disneyland grows, so will Orange County and California.
Florida already has many world-famous tourist attractions. And the new Disney complex promises to complement these existing businesses and will greatly increase the magnetism of Florida's dynamic personality. Not only in the immediate area surrounding Orlando, but throughout the entire state, tourists will find an additional incentive to vacation in Florida.
Word of Disney coming to Florida was certainly the most welcome news that the Florida attractions have ever heard. This man stands out above all others in the entertainment business all over the world, and he should by giving the different kind of emphasis to the attractions, supply a variation that will just be a magnet for millions and millions of people to come here. This, all of our attractions believe, is the greatest thing that ever happened to them and to Florida. And we welcome Walt Disney, his brother Roy, and all the rest of them with open arms.
As chairman of the Florida Travel Council, division of the Florida State Chamber of Commerce, we were all pleased to know that Walt Disney was moving to the state of Florida. We believe that this great attraction will enhance the tourist business manyfold.
I say that when Interstate 95 is completed from New York to Jacksonville, the tourists from our great northeastern market will be flocking through this city in vast numbers. And don't forget that most of this new business attracted by the Disney East will be family business. We will have very, very great increases in the patronage of our hotels, our restaurants, our places of interest, and I would predict that Jacksonville's tourist business, the tourist business of the entire Northeast Florida, will expand vastly when the Disney Enterprise is open.
We are very grateful because we realize that Mr. Disney personifies the same type of attraction that we have here in Busch Garden, namely a family type attraction, an attraction that people are glad to and happy to come back to time and time again. We know that the stimulus on hearing of Walt Disney's projected plans were tremendous right here at the west coast of Florida. We are thrilled. We are patiently waiting for them to come because we realize, too, that this will be another strong leap in the attraction chain here in the state of Florida.
We located on the Miracle Strip of Northwest Florida are happy indeed that Disneyland is coming to Florida. You may wonder why we believe that this fine attraction will be beneficial to us. It's more than 300 miles away, or about 300 miles away. We believe this because we know what happened in California, and we know that millions and millions of tourists will be attracted to Florida by this attraction, and we know that many of them will come through here en route to visit the establishment. This, we know with our seascape and our fishing, will cause many of them to stop, or at least to come back once they have passed through and have seen this location.
Florida has had many great yesterdays, from the first days of exploration to the launching of the nation's first manned spacecraft. Florida has always kept pace with the world that we live in. Florida's tomorrow seems even more promising. With the new $100 million Disney attraction, economic growth will be spurred throughout the entire state. We're proud to be the new home for Disney's largest and most ambitious project, and we certainly welcome Walt Disney to Florida. As governor of the state of Florida, it's been my privilege to be involved in this most exciting new venture.